Hello everyone, to all of my virgins and simps, and to all of the papalapit na Viva Maximals and the Viva Primals. It's your boy, the God Gamer, the Donger, the man himself, the stranger of paradise, Harieth, and telling you, it's Sunday! And you know what that means? It's time for a review of episode 4 of Lovely Ladies Dormitory here on Lovely Ladies Sunday. So bago ang lahat, so I want you all to like the video, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell icon for more of your Vivamax outings. And siguro Made in Malacanang, whenever it's out, whenever Viva Prime is out, I think it's the flagship. Tapos, yeah, tomorrow there will be a special video. We will be tackling the super soldiers ng Darna. And then at the evening, actually it's both evening kasi alis ako, kakain ako sa labas in tomorrow Sunday. Siguro it's one is the super soldier video ng Darna, and the other one is like the Viva Max Awards of 2022. So I have na-formulate ko yung mga nanalo, and I will introduce the winners. I did that while abang nasa Cebu. And yeah, then on Monday there will be also a special video recapping yung mga napanood kong bold sa Viva Max. So stay tuned for that. Pero that is our future content, because today is very lovely as we about to deep dive dito sa past ni Yen Durano, yung character ni Yen Durano na si Jackielyn the dancer, because it's Lovely Ladies Sunday and we're about to review Lovely Ladies Dormitory. So sino nga ba tong si Jackielyn? Maraming hiwagay, pero ang tingin ko sa series ito, pahiwaga ng pahiwagay, kasi yung next episode si Mia, which is a character played by Hershie de Leon, and nanotice ko dito sa episode na to, she got more screen time. Well, last week kasi medyo significant na yung role niya, or dun na pumasok yung pagka-significant ng role niya, and yung others na set aside tuloy, like Stella, poor Stella, nagkalimutan na, parang nung Happy New Year, pinagalitan siya dahil kabit, ngayon, wala, nag-aaway sila sa divorce. So, the episode 4 opens up with the past of Jackielyn. So, Jackielyn was a student who got into it with her teacher na si Rolly. And this, dito nakarating kasi peeping Tom yung dalawang teacher, faculty members ng eskwela na pinapasukan ni Jackielyn, at sinumbong siya sa otoridad. At dito nakita natin na yung tatay ni Jackielyn is living with a stepmother, and Jackielyn just decided to elope with the teacher, Rolly, habang nakikipag-dog style yung dalawa. So, di siya nagpaalam. Kasi busy na makipag-doggy-doggy yung mga step-parents niya. So, umalis siya kasama si Rolly. Little did she know na yung guardian angel niya na si Rolly, nadidemonyo pala. Kasi once nalasing at nakapag-drugs na yung mga kasama niya, pinirsahan na makipagtalik itong si Jackielyn sa kanila. And this also prompts Jackielyn to leave. So, yung parang dito, walang nakikitang true love tuloy si Jackielyn. Wala siyang love sa parents, kasi step-parents. Wala rin siyang nakitang true love dun kay Rolly. And which is sad. This episode is a bit sad. Medyo wala siyang comedic stance. After that New Year scene, nung episode ng New Year, yung nangyari kay Tracy, medyo sumeryoso yung tono ng Lovely Ladies Dormitory. Lalo na yung episode 4. Walang comedic scene. May comedic scene last episode yung kay Super Pechay, pero this is a complete 180 dun sa Super Pechay character. We go towards the present, and Super Pechay is committed with Boss Anarchy for 6 months. Di niya alam kung legal yun sa app, pero dahil nag-deposit si Boss Anarchy na 35,000, eh, pumayag naman itong si Jackielyn. Kasi sudyante naman siya, ilang siya. And she barely has to ends meet. Lalo na tapilay siya as a dancer. So, she really has to ace her gig as Super Petchay. Now, we got a glimpse of Stella and Nico. Nico will try to fight the divorce. I don't really know how divorce works. So, what if the other... What if the guy wants divorce and the woman doesn't? Di ko alam paano yun. So, that's okay. Three. Alma doesn't have a lot of screen time. They just talk about the dealership ni Carlo on in terms of doing illegal drugs as such. And we are... But this one focuses other kay Jackielyn, it also focus on Mia. Mia na napakilala lang sa atin yung sugar daddy ni Mia. They have like one night stand sa bathtub at meron ring one night stand sa dulo ng episode na to. We're gonna talk about that kasi may bloopers dun. So Jackielyn eventually meet up with Boss Anarchy. Nakakalakad na siya ng konti. I think there is a time skip of 6 months here. So, nakakalakad na siya ng konti. And, we also got a glimpse of Tracy coping after the incident nung New Year. Pero, parang tahimik siya. We didn't really get much Tracy also here. It's more like, ayun, yung mga eksena dito nakafocus talaga kay Jackielyn. Jackielyn meets up with Bea, the real name of Boss Anarchy, and they have a hot lesbian action, HLA. Maybe yun yung episode title, I don't know. So, Bea is a software developer, electrical engineer, who has a passion for photography. Parang yung kilala ko. Weird. Di ko alam sino yung artista na yun eh. Maybe I'll look into the credits, pero... Parang bagay dun sa character, dun sa artista maging tomboy eh. She really nailed the look of a tomboy. Pero sa dulo parang ayaw pa ni Jackielyn magkaroon ng seryosong relasyon kay Bea. But she did enjoy the hot lesbian action dun sa last night. And nag-glimpse ni Jackielyn yung nakipag-meet up si Mia sa kanyang sugar daddy. So, there is a blooper here. So, nakikinawag-sex si Mia sa kanyang sugar daddy. After the sex, kita natin yung ass ni Mia. Parang walang cover. Then, after one frame, parang sa next frame ng eksena, meron na siyang tibak. So, yeah, I think they forgot to sabihin kay Hershie during the taping, oy, huwag ka muna mag-tibak. Mayroon pa tayong take. Or they didn't edit it out. They didn't even bother, baka walang makapansin. Pero napansin ko, after makipagtalik, walang suot na underwear si Hershie. Pero in that split frame, meron na siyang underwear. I don't know when's the part Hershie put it. Nakakat naman eh, pero parang ang hirap eh. Kasi pag pinanood mo yung eksena, parang wala na siyang room para suotin yung tibak. Ayun. Also, I feared for this scene kasi akala ko atakin sa puso yung matanda habang ginugulong, gumiling-giling itong si Mia, si Hershie de Leon sa ano niya, sa ari niya. Akala ko talaga pag nag-orgasm yung matanda, maatake sa puso eh. Buti na lang hindi. I was ready to alt F for vivamax. Pag nangyari yun. Pero hopefully yun. So yeah. That's like it. Yung mga eksena dito, yes, they actually double the mature scenes here. And it's also really uncomfortable if you think about it. Student-teacher relationship, the R word, bawal ko. Panggagahasa, yun, sige. Sugar daddy. It's really those uncomfortable scenes. Pero nag-build up to that hot lesbian action na yun pa yung komportable na panoorin eh. Diba? Yun pa yung sexing panoorin eh. Yung pagtatalik ng tomboy sa kanong babae. Pero yung iba, wala eh. May one night stand, may ingap, sexually panggagahasa. Yun. So what do I think of this episode? This episode has a really serious overtone compared sa mga last episode ng Lovely Ladies Dormitory. Napaka-seryoso nito. It got livened up when Jackielyn met Bea. But sa ano, in the sense of things, the music really is slow. It's more ano eh, more on the characters dito. And I'm not sure why, pero si Jackielyn lang, Jackielyn so far, yung lang, siya lang may dedicate na backstory. We don't have a backstory for Tracy. We don't have a backstory for Alma. We don't have a backstory for Stella. And yung kay Stella eh, kinakabahan ako eh. Baka makalimutan na yung character niya eh. Wala kada episode, pabawas eksena niya eh. Wala, Stella suffered the first blood syndrome na siya yung unang taya when it comes to storytelling at nawala tuloy na unti-unti naging irrelevant siya, 'di ba? Ika nga. So yeah, that is my review. Recap of Lovely Ladies Dormitory episode 4. Very very sad, very very serious. Hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit that bell icon for more of your bold review. Then on Friday, Nightbird featuring Chloe Jenna and Christine Bermas. And then next Sunday, episode 5. Then, actually Sunday evening, Super Soldiers review ng Darna and also vivamax 2022 awards. And then Monday, I watch all bold movies in 2022 sa vivamax, the summary, the recap. This is your boy, the God Gamer Harriet, telling you goodbye and good night. I should go. Bang.